Welcome back, everyone. In this series of lectures, we are talking about the dynamics of periodic structures. In the previous videos, we have introduced the concepts of periodic structures, and we have also introduced periodic analysis and applied it to discrete spring mass systems. In this lecture, we are going to be talking about periodic bars. Periodic bars have a lot of applications, as we are going to present some of them later, but they are going to be handled just like what we did before in periodic discrete systems. If we imagine that we have a cell, this cell has two parts, each of them has a different material and or cross-section. Each bar can be presented with a bar element. The first one has displacement and force at the left-hand side and displacement and force at the right-hand side. Similarly, the other part has displacements and forces on both sides. When these two elements are assembled, we will get a finite element model for the cell consisting of those two parts, which can be presented as an equation of motion for the two-part bar, as in this equation. These equations have m1 and m2 for masses, k1 and k2 for masses. If you are familiar with finite element modeling, you will see right away that M1 can be presented by an expression for the area, density, and length of the first element, similarly M2, while K1 and K2 can be expressed by the modulus of elasticity, cross-section area, and the length of the second bar. If we introduce those terms into our equations of motion and also transform them into the frequency domain, just like what we did before in the discrete mass spring system, we will get three equations as you can see here. The three equations are in the amplitudes of vibration of U1, U2, and U3, since we are talking about harmonic motion. F1 and F3, while F2 becomes zero here because the one coming from the first element and the one coming from the second element eliminate each other. If you are interested in learning more about how to present bars using finite element modeling, you can check the lectures for the finite element modeling of bars through the Academy of Knowledge website, and the link is given here. You can get the link from the presentation if you download it from the website. Anyway, now we will take these equations and use what we did in the spring mass system in inclinating spring mass systems by removing the second equation, since what we have here, as you can see, U2, the equation corresponding to U2 has a zero right hand side, so we can basically move U1 and U3 to the right hand side and solve for U2, which gives us this expression. Then using this expression into the other two equations, we will get the equations of motion without losing any information of the finite element model. We use the same procedure, as I've said earlier. We use the same procedure in the discrete spring mass systems. Now we can rewrite the equations in terms of a transfer matrix, as we did before, and then get the eigenvalue problem, which is the core of our work in periodic analysis. Here you have this matrix, which we called the T matrix before, and the eigenvalues will be e to the mu, or we may call them lambda. Now, we have everything we need to get to perform our periodic analysis, just like what we did in the spring mass system in the previous lecture. Here, if we change the excitation frequency from 0 to 20,000 radians per second, this is how the eigenvalues will change. Notice the similarity between this model and the one we got for the alternating mass spring systems, basically because what we have here is a 3 degree of freedom system also. So we will get a very similar looking variation of the eigenvalues, and as expected also a similar variation in the stop and the pass bands. Now we can see clearly the stop band here. It extends somewhere between 6,000 radians per second to 11,000 or 12,000 radians per second. If we now have a look at the frequency response, there you are. This is what we are looking for. You can see clearly a drop in the frequency response, drop in the amplitude, even if we have here one of the natural frequencies appearing in the center of the stop band, but the whole thing dropped. This is what we are looking for. Actually, this has been performed experimentally and verified experimentally by Professor Sahil Asiri, and there is a link at the end of this presentation to show for his profile, where you can see his publications. Okay, so now we have this. Let me just get back to the stop bands. Here, the stop bands extending from around 6 or 7,000 radians per second to about 11 to 12,000 radians per second, and you can see here the drop of amplitude extending in the same band. So, from this we can say that the stop band can predict the reduction in the response amplitude, at least numerically. And I've just said a few seconds ago that this has been verified experimentally as well with extremely high accuracy. However, notice that when we modeled the bar here, the bars were modeled using a two-node bar. So the whole cell had only 3 degrees of freedom. If you revise the finite element modeling in dynamics of structures, you will notice that the first frequencies will not be accurate enough if you are using only 2 or 3 degrees of freedom. So I can say confidently that the response I'm seeing here is not the best I can get from a finite element model because of the low number of degrees of freedom I used per cell. To overcome this problem, we will improve the results using three-node elements that we're going to present in the coming video. So what have we done here? We have applied periodic analysis as introduced earlier and as applied to discrete systems. We have applied all what we learned there on the problem of a periodic bar. We obtained similar results, but we are kind of not really sure that the frequency response is accurate enough since we are only using 3 degrees of freedom per cell. So what we're going to be doing in the next video is introduce three-node elements, then use them to present the dynamics of a cell and the dynamics of a bar. I hope that this is not so quick. It's just reapplication of what we have already done before to a new problem. So if it's not that clear, you may revise the previous videos to refresh the information you need. So I hope to see you next video to demonstrate the effect of three-node bar elements on the numerical analysis. See you then.